was like, "Okay, Lord, what do you want me to speak?" And the Lord gave me a word, and he said, "I want you to speak about God confidence." Of course you're going to want me to speak of something that I've always struggled with, but okay. So, that's what I'm going to speak on today, God confidence. And the reason I'm going to speak on it is because I believe that's what God wants y'all to walk in this day and age. He wants y'all to be bold and be strong and not fear anything or anyone, and to walk in God confidence. See, people always ask me, and I'm sorry if I keep looking at my phone, this is where I got my notes. But people always ask me where I get my confidence from. And given the situation that I've been dealt with, like, how can you be so confident? Like, look at it, like, you're in a wheelchair, you're small, my condition is osteogenesis imperfecta, which is a brittle bone disease, so I break easy. I like to describe it as glass. If you drop glass, glass breaks. Well, clean. So, when I was born, a little bit about my testimony. When I was born at 4 pounds with a heart murmur, several fractured bones all over my body, and also heel fractures, and the doctor said that I wasn't going to live long enough. I wasn't going to live past a couple of days, and if I did, I would be dependent on my parents the rest of my life. I wouldn't be able to do anything at all. I'd be totally dependent. And then they said if I did live past a couple of days, that I wouldn't live past 7 years old. Well, I just turned 38 years old. I've known what it's like to almost have your life taken from you, and everything that I've had to overcome from birth to now has helped me to be secure in my identity in Him. I haven't always been that way. I haven't always had the God confidence that I do now, but every circumstance, everything that I've had to overcome has made me stronger and stronger in my God confidence. And, you know, that's to say we all have circumstances. We all go through things, especially being teenagers, growing up, you know, peer pressure. And this day and age in high school, it's a lot different than when I was in high school. So I can't even imagine what you all go through. But y'all have one step higher than everybody else, because you all have God. By reading His word and spending time with Him one-on-one, you will begin to understand, and you will see, and your God confidence will grow in Him. Before, I didn't know that I was spiritual. Before I started to know God and grow my relationship with Him, I never knew that I was spiritually and wonderfully. I didn't know that He loved me with such a love that He died on the cross for me. I didn't know any of that. But as I began to grow my relationship with Him and spend time with Him, I began to learn just how special He was in His sight. Really, all I knew about myself is that I was different, I was weird, I did not fit in. I couldn't do a lot of the things that everybody else could do. And of course that weighs you down, and that makes you feel like useless and worthless. But when I started to get to know God, I started to get to know that, yeah, I'm not like everybody else. I'm unique. I can stand out for Christ. And what better way to stand out is if not for Him. And I may not be able to walk, but I can do all things through Christ. For you all, you know, people might have things that you have certain limitations, but hasn't put any limitations on you at all. So why are you, or maybe not even people, maybe just you, you put limitations on yourself. But why are you putting them on yourself when God doesn't put them on you? God says that you can do everything through Him who strengthens you. The Father loves you all with such a love that He gave His life for you. And for me, that's what drives me to be the best that I can be in Him. It's what gives me the courage to be a leader and not a follower. And it gives me the strength to show people that I can... Oh, it gives me the strength to show people that I don't have any limitations. And like I said, God doesn't limit me, so why should I? And why should I allow people to limit me? Right. And people are going to see you and do to you what you allow them to. Right? It's your job to teach people to respect you. It's your job to love yourself the way God loves you. And when you do that, other people, like, let's talk about love for a minute. You know, I know all you young people probably want a boyfriend, a girlfriend, you know. And mom and dad doesn't let you have one, but you still have one on the down low. With another human being, you need to have a relationship with yourself. That's the most important relationship that you can have. You need to see yourself the way God sees you. You need to love yourself the way God loves you. Because when you begin to do that, other people will love you that same way, in that same way. Other people are going to treat you and love you the way you love and treat yourself. Amen. And that I learned. Because before I knew God, people judged me a lot. You know, because I'm small. I'm in a wheelchair. And if you don't talk to me, a lot of people think I have a mental disability. Just because I have a physical disability. It's not until you get to know me, until you talk to me, that you're like, wow, she's smart. I mean, I'm not tuning my own heart. They're like, wow, you know. But it's the way you carry yourself, the way you present yourself to people. And if you respect yourself, other people are gonna respect you. If you don't respect yourself, don't expect respect from everybody else either. And that goes the same with love as well. The way you love yourself is the same type of love that you're going to attract. That's why you should first love the Lord and have Him show you how to love yourself. And sometimes that's a process as well. It's a journey. It doesn't happen in an instant because we go through so many things on a day-to-day basis. You know, we go through things, circumstances come our way, you know, the enemy tries to knock us down. But I've learned that not to give the enemy the power that he doesn't deserve. You give the power to the Lord. As long as you stay focused on God, the enemy will try and try. But when you see that you're focused on God, and you're focused on your blessing, and you're focused on going from glory to glory, he'll give up and he'll get tired and he'll be like, man, I can't mess with that one.
That's right.
Amen. So now, I'm just going to talk about a little bit about what I've accomplished in my life. I did graduate high school. And the only reason I'm going to talk about it is because I came from people expecting me accomplish anything. Well, I went through high school, graduated high school, and let me tell you, in high school, I had to fight to take a certain test to graduate because I wanted to go to college. And they, because I had a physical disability, they thought I had a mental disability. So they were telling me, no, basically they were telling me, you're not capable of passing this test, so they just wanted to pass me. And I was like, no, I am capable, I want to go to college, you know, I want a future, I have a future. So I took the test, I graduated, I went on to college, I got 2 certificates, and I worked for a while. I maintained my own place. I have a vehicle, or I had a vehicle. I'm in the process of getting a new one. I drive. I have my own place, and that is all with God's strength and God's help. Only God. Only God. And after that, after I worked for a while, then my health wasn't too well. I had a lot of respiratory issues, so I would get sick of that. So I had to find a way to get some type of exercise. I was trying anything and everything, and so I can't lift weights. I can't go to the gym. I'm small. I can't do anything. So I started doing Zumba, and a year after of doing Zumba, I became a Zumba instructor. And you're thinking, wow, like, how do you do Zumba? Well, it was, and I want to say this, I don't like saying this, but because you're youth, and I'm just telling you, just because this is, I want you all to take from this, is to be a leader, to stand up, to break boundaries, and you know, that's what God created you for. You have a destiny, you have a purpose. And, well, so. And, but, before that, don't think it was easy. I had a lot of people telling me, you can't do that. How are you gonna do that? No. People won't go to your class and things like that. I had a lot of people telling me I couldn't, and I wouldn't, and I shouldn't. Especially in the fitness world, and I was like, and they would discourage me a little bit, but then I would go back to God's word. And I'd be like, well, the Lord said I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. If He said I can do it, I am gonna do it. So I had to talk myself through it and keep going. I keep going and keep overcoming all the obstacles that came my way, and I did it with the Lord. And so I did a couple of years of traveling with Zumba, giving my testimony, them showing God to them, demonstrating God's power, and just, you know, having fun doing Zumba, and it was awesome. And so I say that to say that, not to put limits on yourself. When you begin to see the greatness that God has instilled in you, people will in turn see it too. So like after I became a Zumba instructor and I started showing people that, you know, and I started leading classes, people were like, wow. And I was like, okay, well, it's just one of me. And I started having other, and then I broke that boundary for other people in wheelchairs and other disabled people to say, hey, you know what, she can do it, I can do it. And that showed them like, you know what, I can do it. And things like that. So that was like an awesome feeling for me to see that God used me in that way. And the whole time, it's all about glorifying of how powerful He is and how He has no limitations. And it allows me to minister to these people and show them and tell them, you can do all things Christ has prayed into you. You know, don't limit yourself. Don't, people will limit you, but you don't limit yourself. He doesn't limit you. Amen. Amen. If I would have listened to all the people who projected their fears onto me, I wouldn't have accomplished all that I have in this lifetime. Because many along this life have told me that I wouldn't be able to. And so instead of allowing people or yourself to project their fears on you, allow God to project His confidence on you. Because when you allow people to project their fears on you, you won't walk out your purpose, the purpose He has for you. But when you allow God to project His God confidence on you, you can do all things through Christ. But, there's a big but. It all starts with you. So be unique. Be you. You are beautiful. Even the men are beautiful too. You're handsome in God's sight. And you are strong. Because if you weren't strong, you wouldn't be where you're at today. When the world says you're not good enough, or when you start feeling like you're not good enough, get a second opinion. Open up your Bible and see what God says about you. My prayer for all of you all is to be bold and walk in God's confidence, to be able to stand up for greater good. Because there's too much evil. We don't need any more evil here in this world. We need love, peace, joy, understanding,